Okay, now we're going to see updating products, deleting products, deleting all products. Okay. This will give all products. Sorry, what is that? If you say like this, this we already seen, right? Nothing is coming because I stopped the server. I need to add some product now. Okay. I'll add one product here. I'll add one more product here. Shirt. Quantity is price is 300. Quantity is 10. I'll add one more product. What can I add? Okay. Shirt, then shirt, t-shirt, let's say the t-shirt, 500, quantity is 15, 16. So three products added. When you say the three products are coming, now I'll go to update. I want to update third product. I want to update a third product. For that, there is a one method called put mapping, one annotation called put mapping. Using put mapping, we can update the particular object. For example, I want to update some product information. For that update information, we need to send as a object, product object. That is form of request body. Then which product you want to update? I want to update particular product ID, right? That product ID we need to pass here. As usual, I'm going to using lambda expression to identify which product I want to update. Okay, using this lambda expression, I'm getting the corresponding product. Now I'm removing the product, then I'm adding the new product to the collection. This is a way of updating in the collection object. Okay. Since we are not using the database, I'm updating in this way. So when you do update, we have to use put mapping annotation. Okay. This is the update part. Now we'll see example of this. What is the endpoint for this? Endpoint should be localhost product, the same thing as the product. What product you want to update? I want to update third product. Okay. Now I'm going to create one more tab. The request mapping, request method is a put method. Header is content type. You have to add content type equal to application JSON. Then body, request body, select raw, copy this request, put here itself. I want to update third object, right? So I want to update third object, this t-shirt blue. Just I am adding t-shirt blue. Price is 600, quantity is 15. Now I'm going to send the request. I have added some log statement here using system.out.println update product starts. Whenever send a request, this statement will print, this code gets executed. Okay, I'll go to send now. See, after updating, I am sending the request 600, 1500 t-shirt blue. The response coming 3 t-shirt blue 615. Okay, there's the first, the in this particular postman, the first section is a request part, second section is a response part, which is coming from the server. C status equal to 200. Okay, here whenever I pass product ID, I am matching the product ID from the product, I am removing the product from the collection, then I am adding the new product here. Then that new product I am returning as a response. That's the reason it's printing here the newly added value here. Okay, this is called through this way only we need to use update endpoint. This is our update endpoint. Now I want to delete particular product. For that, we need to use a delete mapping. Delete mapping. See here, delete mapping followed by product ID. Which product you want to delete? I am passing this as a path variable. That variable will have whatever value will going to pass here. That value assigned to this variable. Okay. Here, I am using lambda expression to identify which product we want to delete. That product coming here, just I am removing here. This endpoint also we have to use that same thing. After copying, don't forget to put delete. If you keep put, it will go to update. We have to change the delete. Then only it will go under call this method. Okay. So delete product starts. I am adding one log here. Whenever I want to delete this product, right? This is a delete call. I don't want to pass request body. I just want to add a path variable. That's it. I'm removing the request. A request body. Now I want to send a request. Okay. I sent. After sending, I'm getting a response which object deleted. That response I'm getting here. Now we're going to check all the product. Get all the product. When you get all the product, the expected result is the third item should not come. See the log here. Delete start. Delete point get called. So one item from the removed, one item removed from the collection. If you say get all products, this particular object get removed from collection. Let's see. See here, 1 and 2 only we have. That particular object is get deleted. Okay. Now you need to say delete all product. Okay. Here I'll going to return string object. After deleting, return all products are deleted. I want to return this message. So since I changed the server side, I want to restart. Okay, we started. Now I want to use this the same endpoint with delete mapping with which endpoint we need to use the same endpoint of get product all for deleting also, but you need to use delete mapping. Okay, so change this to delete. Now I'm going to execute that. Something happened here. Internal server error. We got internal server error. Let's see what's happened here. Oh, I got it. Why? I'll get null point exception. Why? Because I changed this statement, right? I added some code, then restarted the application. After restarting application, what's happening here? The collection object became a null. Okay. Become a null because I stopped the server, restart again, I restarting the server. So your collection object become a null object. That's the reason it's giving the null pointer exception at line number 58. Line number 58. When I try to clear, this is a null object. That's the reason it's giving the error. Now we want to add some product. I will add one product, two product. We'll add 1, 2. Price 205. So two products added. I want to view all product. So get method, the same endpoint. See two products are coming here. I want delete all the product now. Delete endpoint. I'll going to delete now. I'll remove this log, remove this error message. Send. See, all products are deleted. See this method. This method get executed and they printed this statement. Then it's cleared all the product from the collection. Then return this message. That message printing here. If you want to view any product, nothing will print. Let's see, empty array is printing, empty array is printing, nothing is coming. I think, hope you understand better how to implement, how to create a web service endpoint using Spring Boot. If you have any question, please comment in the comment section. Definitely, I will going to clarify. Okay. In the next video, we'll go through some concept for 5 minutes. Then I'll going to change this application with database, not MySQL. Spring Boot itself having a default database. Okay, I'll going to use the database to implement this example. After that, we'll use MySQL. Okay. Okay, guys. Until then, bye bye from Suresh Kesavan. Please subscribe if you are not yet. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thank you so much for watching this full video. Until next video, bye bye from Suresh Kesavan.